Good evening and welcome to our evening prayer as we come to reflect on the day and to give thanks to God. As I was walking over, I was reflecting on the fact that during the day we've heard the noise of the children playing in the next door school, reminder that that element of life is returning to something more like normality. In the road too, the amount of traffic going to the vaccination centre reminds that that's well underway. And I suddenly realised that you can notice both these things because it's still light. Though I need to speak quickly, the light is fading. And as you start to notice these things, you notice that yesterday on Sunday, the clergy broke our own record for the number of steps for the wells in Cafford, giving us a new all-time record. On Saturday, wonderful number of people were able to gather here for the celebration of reconciliation. The number two who were able, because of the stewards, etc., to attend on Sunday. There's an awful lot to give thanks for. I was going to mention that my cough is almost gone too, but there was a little bit just a reminder, but even that is fading. We come this evening to reflect on all the gifts that God gives us. And it gives us a confidence, because if he has already given us so much, then when later we bring to him our needs and the petitions that we've been asked to pray this evening, we can do so in that context of a confidence in God's goodness. It must surely have been that confidence in God that enabled Mary to say her yes. And so we begin at this traditional hour with the Angelus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, thy Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross, be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. O God, come to our aid. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. God of thy pity, unto us thy children, bend down thine ear in thine own loving kindness, and all thy people's prayers and vows ascending, hear we beseech thee. Look down in mercy from thy seat of glory. Pour on our souls the radiance of thy presence. Drive from our weary hearts the shades of darkness, lightening our footsteps. Free us from sin by might of thy great loving. Cleanse thou the sordid, loose the fetid spirit. Spare every sinner, raise with thine own right hand all who are fallen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our eyes are turned to the Lord. We look for his mercy. To you have I lifted up my eyes, you who dwell in the heavens, my eyes like the eyes of slaves on the hand of their lords, like the eyes of a servant on the hand of her mistress. So our eyes are on the Lord our God, till he show us his mercy. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy. We are filled with contempt. Indeed, all too full is our soul with the scorn of the rich, with the proud man's disdain. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our eyes are turned to the Lord. We look for his mercy. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. If the Lord had not been on our side, this is Israel's song, if the Lord had not been on our side when men rose against us, then they would have swallowed us alive when their anger was kindled. Then would the waters have engulfed us, the torrent gone over us. Over our head would have swept the raging waters. Blessed be the Lord who did not give us a prey to their teeth. Our life, like a bird, has escaped from the snare of the fowler. Indeed, the snare has been broken and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. God chose us in his Son, and made us his adopted sons. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. He chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. He destined us in love to be his sons through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he freely bestowed on us in the beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace, which he lavished upon us. He has made known to us in all wisdom and insight the mystery of his will, according to his purpose, which he set forth in Christ. His purpose he set forth in Christ as a plan for the fullness of time, to unite all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. God chose us in his Son, and made us his adopted sons. Think of God's mercy, my brothers, and worship him, I beg you, in a way that is worthy of thinking beings, by offering your living bodies as a holy sacrifice, truly pleasing to God. Do not model yourselves on the behavior of the world around you, but let your behavior change, modeled by your new mind. This is the only way to discover the will of God and to know what is good, what it is that God wants, what is the perfect thing to do. I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Jesus walked straight through them all and went away. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me. Holy his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones and raises the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his sons forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Jesus walked straight through them all and went away. Let us call on the name of the Lord Jesus, who saves his people from their sins. Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on us. Christ our Lord, you gave yourself up for the church to make her holy. Renew her once more through the spirit of repentance. Good Master, let young people discover the way of life which you have planned for each of them. May they be faithful to your grace and fulfill your will for them. Give hope to the sick and make them well again. Help us to comfort and take care of them. In baptism, you have made us children of the Father. May we live for you now and always. Grant to the faithful departed peace and glory. Let us reign with them one day in your heavenly kingdom. With a young couple this afternoon, preparing for their marriage, struggling to know what date to best choose. So we pray for them and for all the couples in our parish preparing for marriage, praying that it may be for them the celebration, not just of their love, but of the love of family and friends. This evening, the gathering of families whose children are preparing for First Holy Communion. We keep them in our prayers. We pray for all the children returning to school today. Pray particularly for the teachers and staff of their schools. We continue to pray for Pope Francis as he undertakes his pastoral visit to Iraq. Pray especially for the people of that country, for the strengthening and security of faith. Jocelyn prays in thanksgiving for the safe delivery of her niece Cassie, to her niece Cassie of a baby boy. We keep him in our prayers through the cleft, though he has a cleft palate, he may still be able to feed. For the people of Myanmar, that there may be a peaceful resolution to the ongoing conflict. We give thanks for all those working in the vaccine program, remembering especially those volunteers giving of their time so generously. Philomena asks that we might pray for Kathleen, who's had a stroke. Anne asks that we might pray for the health of Matthew and for the support of his family. We pray for all those who are sick in the hospital and the care homes and for the staff who minister to them. We continue to pray for Lily, 8 months old and taken into hospital at the weekend. For Graham, battling with cancer. For Agnes, experiencing breathing difficulties and anxiety. For Warren, for the healing of his cancer. And we continue to pray for Catherine, Chris, and Caroline, Anthony and Mariana, Peter, Jean, Joanna's baby boy, David and Helen Osborne, Bernie, remember especially Father Brian Taylor and his wife Hilary. Mervyn asks that we might pray on the first anniversary of the death of his sister Dolly. Pray too for the repose of the soul of Avelina, for Marie's father who has died, for the comforting of family and friends, for Alberto who died recently of COVID, and remember too his wife and sons who are grieving. Remember the clergy who served this diocese, remembering today on his anniversary, Father Dennis Tui. And we pray for all those who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith, and for all those who grieve. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. By your unfailing mercy, Lord, purify and guard your church, and since without you she cannot stand fast, support and guide her always by your grace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We don't pray a decade of the Rosary now, because at 7 we will be praying the Rosary together. So if you're able, do please return then. So meanwhile, we conclude with the Marian antiphon, the wrong one, but the one that I'm half able to sing. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, Espes Nostra Salve. A te amanus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et flentes in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea rego, advocata nostra, illos tuos, misericordes loculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fruntum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O dulce. Crucis, Virgo Maria. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.